athletic like that, which can't, physically cannot happen, was very upsetting from a fellow pro.
When you hear him say that you were positioning his hand a certain way in the glove, can you explain what you were saying to me before we were filming?
Well, if you watch Tyson, and if you are, you know, a Tyson fan, like we all are, and you watch his fights, and you watch him train for years, if you see him on the pads or anything, Tyson, he flicks the jab. You know, he wasn't like, you know, with my style where I was, you know, use my upper body and I'd throw a jab stiff. Tyson would, you know, would throw from low. He'd throw from high. He'd leave it there. He'd backhand. That's how he punched. Do you know what I mean? He's very unorthodox. He would slap the right hand, chop the right hand down because he's 6'10". Do you know what I mean? He has to throw the right hand at a certain angle. And Tyson, because he has such height and reach advantages, he flicks the jab and he leaves it there, and he'll leave his left hand there, and he'll leave his right hand there. No one was better with that style of fighting than Floyd Mayweather Jr., you know, stiff-arming his opponent, where he's leaving an open glove, you know, to his opponent. That's just type in Tyson's style. And when I used to fight, I used to, like, me gloves, and I used to try and, you don't allow it now, but I used to, like, me tape right up as high to the knuckle as possible. I used to, like, my wrist, you know, firmly, you know, like that. But Tyson, he likes to flick the punch. So Tyson wants a loose wrist because he flicks his shots. He doesn't throw it stiff like I did. He backhands it and throws it, you know. So that's why Tyson is. And when Tyson, you know, he went, pull me glove up. Said, pull me glove up. He didn't say, get that horseshoe out and stick that in it, man. You know what I mean? He said, pull me glove up, because he doesn't like it has fastened right tightly around his wrists, because he likes to flick the shots. You know, he's not a, you know, he doesn't punch with his whole body, Tyson, like certain fighters. He likes to flick and jab and poke his jab and leave it there. And that's why he doesn't like, he likes mobility in his wrist rather than having it locked, yeah.
Ben Davison's.
Those are the words of Ricky Hatton as he explained the glove situation, okay? And now Ricky Hatton was his guy. I believe he was his guy in both fights. No, he was not. He was in the first fight, okay? And the first fight was Glove Gate 1. And again, you know, we're talking about this shit and it's damn near 2021, okay? But we're talking about something that's almost 2 years old. So the fight's almost 2 years old, but they're still talking about it today. It just shows a lot, you know, how drawn out this is and how people are looking for so many different things. And it's really ridiculous. But anyway, he was explaining what Wilder, you know, accused him of Hatton, of his glove. Pulling his glove. He was pulling it up. He wasn't pulling it down. You know, his gloves was flimsy. Anybody could see that his glove was loose. He explained why it's loose. You know, he wanted it loose. Just like I keep telling people, the interview that I had with his friend, with his very good friend, Tay Jones, you know, I showed him, like, okay, the way he was flicking it, it would make a whip effect. And a guy that doesn't really commit to punches, as Ricky Hatton already verified, okay, he's not the type of dude that sits down on his punches, not all the time. Now, he can, and at times he will. And in the times he did, he hurt Wilder, and that was in the first fight. Nobody talks about that shit. If you look at a lot of fighters or a lot of channels that talk about all this that's going on, they never talk about the 12th round. They'll tell you about they'll talk about, oh, well, he should have been knocked out, or the referee didn't do his job, or the referee had a late count, okay? And they'll talk about that, but they don't want to talk about what happened when Tyson Fury got up. When he got up, he actually started fighting Wilder back, and he caught Wilder with some good shots, and Wilder buckled, okay? He buckled. He did that, it was worse than Joshua when Povetkin hit him, because when he hit that, he did a stumble. And I was like, oh, snap. Deontay Wilder is buckled. In fact, I will leave the source. I have it on Instagram where he caught him with a flush right hand and he followed with a left hook. Tyson Fury did. And when he caught Wilder, Wilder buckled, and it, you know, that knocked him off his setting. That's what happens. Okay. So he hurt him then. That's why Wilder didn't want to really commit like he did, because you, if you notice, he was swinging wildly until he got caught with that punch. And when he got caught with that punch, you know, they locked up, you know, and they were in a clinch, and then it kind of slowed down until the last maybe 12 seconds of that fight. And this is what we're talking about. So Ricky Hatton has a right to defend himself, because that's what you do when someone says you did something. You see what I'm saying? Someone said you did this, someone said you did that. And since everyone said that what Deontay Wilder did or said, he had a right to come out and say he either did or didn't, not get someone else to do so. But I do remember in that fight, while Fury was pulling his trunks up. You can't pull your trunks up if it's out of your wrist like that. You know what I mean? And I think Fury did that shit to flick those shots because he didn't want to get hit by one of the hardest right hands in the boxing game right now. That's why. Because he knew one thing you can counter a jab over is what, people? A right hand. So if you think Tyson Fury was cheating, if you want to call that cheating, people, that's like some misdemeanor shit at best. Okay, yes, it was out of the glove. It was flimsy. He was flicking with it. He ain't the only one that did that shit. He ain't the only one that opened his hand up. Okay, he ain't the only one that did that or stiffed it to keep the right hand from coming over and hitting you in the head. That's what happens. That happened several times in that fight. It happened the second fight because Fury knew all this guy has is a right hand. Stop the right hand from landing. You can get this guy out of here. And that's exactly what he did. And, you know, and I think what spooked Wilder was, Wilder looked spooked. Okay, he looked spooked. He didn't know really what to do or how to handle of Tyson Fury coming at him, sitting down on those punches. He didn't know how to handle that shit. And it might have scared the cowboy shit out of him. Honestly, it might have scared him. You know what I mean? Yeah, he exercised the rematch clause to save face. But like all this other stuff that you created or people gave you to create was strategic. You know what I'm saying? And you wait till somebody says, hey, the contract is over, and wait for them to get a whole nother fighter or look at other fighters. Then you come out with a fucking poem, another goddamn poem. You know what I mean? Quit your dumb poems and say, hey, that ain't going to happen. I want to fight him. I'll fight you in the UK anytime, anywhere. Fuck what Shelly Finkel says. I'm tired of Shelly Finkel talking over Deontay Wilder. He did it when Deontay turned out all that money too, didn't he? Okay, I don't want to get upset, but I'm just telling you guys the facts. And Ricky Hatton himself explained, hey, that wasn't me. You can't do that type of shit. We didn't put no horseshoe and shit in the gloves like that. And everybody's now is so surprised because they didn't listen to all the LDBC stuff. Those were just channels and the people that watched those channels. They only knew that. Now Wilder has came out. This is now new news to everyone else. You understand? So it's one of those situations where people are now left to defend themselves. You know, you had Freddie Roach in the corner. You had Ben Davison in the corner. You had Ricky Hatton in the corner. He accused Ricky Hatton, you know, and then like Tay Jones said, well, hey, yeah, keep the jab, Ben, yeah, keep the jab. Okay, well, yeah, that's what he's supposed to do. Whipping that shit in his face, you know, keeping it far, keeping Wilder far, far away because he has more reach than Wilder. I don't know how much, but he does. And if you know you can flick it or you can backhand it, which is illegal again. Again, that's misdemeanor shit. That ain't nothing that like y'all accusing him of. And you guys really don't know and can really prove what the fuck he had in it. If he had anything in it. Because if he did, you motherfuckers would have found it. Mark Breland, or if Mark Breland was compromised like you guys claimed, JD's. That's your man right there. But you want to give up. You want to give Mark Breland the whole fucking guilt bag. The whole guilt bag you want to give this man because you can't come up with the reason you had a draw and you lost. But now all of a sudden, why is all this shit in the first fight becoming so important now? It didn't have to be so important now. That shit should have been talked about then, 2 years ago. We should have been talking about this shit. This is November, right? We should have been talking about this shit late December and on through January of 2019. That's when we should have been talking about it. Not damn near 2021 when Wilder took a loss. And oh, by the way, that's been like 10 months ago. You see what I'm saying? Like that type of thing and this type of stuff, you know, it has to be addressed. Because when you don't address it, they just keep talking. They want to hear somebody say something, but everybody has a right to speak their own mind. That's my thing. Either you agree with it or disagree. Hey, speak your own mind. And that's my problem with Wilder. I don't think he did speak his own mind. I think he sat back because he really didn't know. He really didn't know what happened. He know he just had an off night for one. You know, it was a different things. He was at a different weight. Fury came in with a different style. You know what I mean? He was getting beat up like that. Understand something. Wilder's a tough man. He's a tough man, but he's also more than tough. He's stubborn. And any guy that's stubborn, any unbeaten guy can be a stubborn guy. And that's exactly what Wilder was in that ring. And what happened, Wilder did not know how to deal with that. Okay, they only trained going forward with Wilder, landed the right hand. You know what I mean? Maybe Mark Breland was probably the guy that was telling him to do something else, but he didn't listen to him anyway. So it really didn't make any difference. So if you don't practice something with training, regardless of what the trainer knows or what he wants to teach you, if you don't exercise that in the training camp, it doesn't matter. So that's why he got beat up. See, all this shit has to do with preparation. He wasn't prepared. He thought he needed to be bigger, which I said from day one when I heard that was stupid. He was stupid. You know what I mean? He's a tall, lean guy. Let him stay that way. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. It just, you know, it may have slowed him down. That plus the costume might have did something. You know what I mean? But the spike water, like Ricky Hatton said, that shit would have popped up in the drug test. And let me tell you, think about the drug test, people. Let me tell you guys something about the drug test. Do you understand you can't even have like Powerade or Smart Water? Now you can have like Fiji and stuff like that, the Zanny. You can't have shit like that. You can't have certain vitamins in there because it gives you an edge. Okay, you can't. It's so tedious that certain things you can't take because they don't want it to register as something else, or small traces of this or small traces of that. That's a very stringent test. It is for people. It's for people that took something and didn't even know they took it. So that tells you that shit, if he would have had something spiked like that, it would have came up. Now, if something would have came up in Wilder's system, then maybe I could understand it. That's that, because it's already there and he can't explain himself how it got there. But it was nothing in their test to confirm that. See, all this shit is dead end. You can talk all day long about what you feel. But if you can't prove it, that's the tough thing. You can know it in your soul that somebody did something, but you can't prove the shit. That's the problem. And if you know you can't prove it, I think, and I was hoping Wilder knew this, because he would knew, like, I can't really prove this shit. I just know the motherfucker cheated me. But one thing's apparent, he believes that he was cheated. If he believes that he was cheated, that's one thing. But if he can prove that he was cheated, that's a totally different thing. Again, I wish Wilder the best. But to do it the way he did it, I wouldn't have done it. I would have done it Dakota way. I would have shut the fuck up and wait for Tyson Fury to do that with somebody else. Somebody that was more experienced. Somebody so that coach wouldn't have been cheesing and skinning and grinning and doing all this bullshit. Okay? Doing all this here. He wouldn't have been doing it. He'd been watching the motherfucker wrap the damn wraps. Okay? And he'd been watching the gloves. Like Nassim Richardson did. That's what he would have done. And then he could say, now you motherfuckers know what I'm talking about. Just like Cotto did. But he ain't Cotto. Because now he said some shit. If Tyson Fury was cheating, go figure. You can't catch him now. He's already cheated you without proof. Will some doctor say how you was hit? How hard you was hit? That shit ain't gonna be enough. I'm gonna tell you that right now. If it's that, you got a dent in your head. Was it a crack? Was it a fracture? A dent? Come on, bro. Come the fuck on with that. Come on with that. Come on. You know what I mean? Anyway, hey, again, I wish him the best. And obviously, hopefully, he has enough evidence. But based on what we've seen thus far, I ain't seen shit that can indict or, you can accuse somebody or can make or can have Tyson Fury holding that guilty bag. But anyway, that's my rant. My rant's over. You guys tell me what you think about Ricky Hatton's statement. Of course, please subscribe. And you guys been Counterpunch. Peace.